Hi, I'm Jim Smyrniotopoulos, and this is MedPick's Case of the Week, number 698. We have no significant financial disclosures nor conflicts to report. Our patient is a 41-year-old man who presents with a two-day history of severe dizziness and sudden-onset vertigo. His symptoms began abruptly after he performed sit-ups during his annual physical fitness test. A non-contrast screening CT demonstrates multiple areas of abnormal low attenuation involving the right cerebellar hemisphere and tonsil. These are easier to see with a stroke window setting. Flare MRI demonstrates similar areas of abnormal signal hyperintensity involving the cerebellum, including the tonsil. And these are confirmed by comparing the T2 MR and the diffusion-weighted image, which demonstrates areas of restricted diffusion involving the right cerebellar hemisphere and the right cerebellar tonsil. If we look at the MR angiogram, we can see the normal signal from the internal carotid arteries, but if we look carefully at the posterior circulation, we can see the left vertebral artery, the basilar, and the posterior cerebral arteries, but we do not identify any signal related to the patient's right vertebral artery. So this is a patient that has a problem in the territory of the posterior circulation, the right vertebral artery. It could be dissection, thrombosis, or embolism. This is a patient with a right vertebral artery dissection involving the territory of the posterior inferior cerebellar artery. And this was confirmed by a catheter angiogram, which is not shown. Vertebral artery dissection is a common cause of stroke in patients under the age of 55 and accounts for approximately a quarter of the strokes in this group. The incidence is described as being as high as 5 per 100,000 people per year. It may be the result of severe trauma, but it may also be spontaneous, associated with relatively trivial trauma, including coughing, vomiting, sports, neck manipulation, weightlifting, gymnastics, sit-ups, and other activities, including rapid turning of the head and brushing your teeth. The clinical presentation for vertebral dissection includes unilateral headache and/or neck pain, symptoms of ischemia in the posterior circulation, which may include dizziness. Some patients will present with the Wallenberg lateral medullary syndrome, which includes vertigo, nystagmus, ataxia, falling towards the lesion, hoarseness, dysphagia, intractable hiccups, and loss of pain and temperature. These are all related to ischemia or occlusion of the posterior inferior cerebellar artery. The risk factors for vertebral dissection include minor trauma, as mentioned before, hypertension, fibromuscular dysplasia, which is identified in up to 15% of patients, and various forms of connective tissue disease, including Ehlers-Danlos, Marfan syndrome, autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease, and osteogenesis imperfecta. The most common site of vertebral dissection includes the transversarial or foraminal portion of the vertebral artery, or V2 section, and the atlas loop, or V3 section. Complications of dissection include ischemic events, TIAs in 10% of patients, and up to two-thirds of the patients have cerebellar infarction. And the treatment includes heparin and then oral warfarin to achieve an INR of 2 to 3, and this may be supplemented with antiplatelet agents, including aspirin. These wonderful schematic diagrams were provided by Frank Gallard and Radiopedia via Wikipedia. We can see here in the frontal and lateral projection the vertebral arteries coming off the subclavian, entering the transverse foramen of the cervical spine, and then looping around to enter the skull. Again, the most common locations for dissections are the V3 or atlas loop and the V2 foraminal or transversarial portions of the vertebral artery. So in conclusion, this is a patient with a right vertebral dissection and PICA infarction that was associated with sit-ups, documented on the MR, the CT scan, and on the MR angiogram. I'm Jim Smyrniotopoulos. I appreciate your attention and thank you very much. I've approved this message.